Thank you very much.
That's very nice of you. I certainly appreciate that. Welcome to the program. My name is David Letterman, and we got a fine one tonight. What's the date, Paul? What do we got? What's going
today,
on?
Today, Ronnie Spector Day.
That's right, and but that's not exactly how it appears on the calendar.
Oh, well, it's the 28th of some month.
No, it's the 28th of, no, it's September. Yeah, almost the end of
end
the month.
Of, yeah.
And I don't know if you're aware of this, but there's some progress going on from the White House today between President Reagan and Mr. Andropov of the Soviet Union. I'm really hopeful here. They're making, I think, some important headway. In the event now of World War III, they hammered out today, I guess we'll be the shirts and they'll be the skin. So that was... got that settled. That's all you need to worry about. We got a good show here tonight. Father Guido Sarducci will be with us. And as Paul mentioned, lead singer of the Ronettes, Ronnie Spector, will be joining us in a couple of minutes. Now, this woman really represents a major period of importance in American music, doesn't she? What was that? What the hell happened? Did the lights go out?
Something happened.
Oh, I thought perhaps I needed a checkup. I thought, good Lord.
I'll tell you what she represents to me.
Yeah.
She was to me, back in, I don't know, 63 or so, when Be My Baby hit, she was like a voice just stretching up, reaching up to me in Canada, a little kid up there in the north, saying, come down, come to New York. Come and get involved in the business. Come. Maybe there's a girl like me for you here in the city. That's what she meant to me. So tonight is like... you know, I'm just
okay, that's
teenage heaven, Dave.
Anybody else have that reaction to... Okay, well, no, but in addition to that, a very important figure in...
seminal performer in the... and it is... That's a real word.
Make it sound like we have an Indian here tonight, isn't
it? That means like, you know...
Oh, I know, yes, I know
close to the source. The source of a lot of feeling and sound.
That's right.
Rock and roll.
This is the woman who is responsible for bringing Paul from Canada. Ronnie Spector will be here tonight. And also a gentleman, he was supposed to be here last night and we ran out of time. The man who sings backwards, David Furor, is here. And... thank you, Paul. We're very happy to have our next guest with us tonight. As Paul indicated earlier, in the early 60s, the dominant sound in American music was the sound of groups like the Shangri-Las, the Supremes, and this group. First, the Ronettes, in footage from a new video cassette entitled Girl Groups, The Story of a Sound, and we are very delighted to have the lead singer of the Ronettes with us tonight. Please welcome Ronnie Spector. Ronnie.
Favorites.
are you?
Hello.
Good to see you.
Why don't you
drop this off over there somewhere?
Okay.
Come on up here and have a seat. Thank you very much, Will. Thank you, guys. You're terrific, by the way. Well, you sound great. You sound
thank you very much, terrific. David.
And the guy sounded very good, I thought, also.
I love you, Paul.
We love you.
The Woody Allen of rock and roll.
The Woody Allen of rock and roll.
Yeah.
Oh!
You know what I mean?
Boy.
He's adorable.
Ronnie, tell me how your group got started.
Well, we started out, we were at the Peppermint Lounge waiting online.
What year was this?
This was 1962.
And what happened when you're waiting in line? Who were you waiting with?
We did this intentionally. We dressed alike. We wore our hair in beehives, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And the management came outside and said, "Hey, girls, you're late." And I said, "Shh, girls, don't say a word." We went inside and we got on stage, and that was the beginning of the Ronettes.
Now, what did you do on stage once you got in there?
We danced a lot.
Yeah. And these were, this was the original group, the Ronettes?
Oh, yeah.
Who else made up the group? You and?
My sister and my first cousin.
Uh-huh. And the group named after?
Well, the Ronettes, the Parkettes, the Rockettes.
But your name, essentially.
Yes.
Yeah, sure. And,
Well, in those days, that's what they did.
Yeah.
Shirley Sherrill, you know, my name was Shirley.
Yeah, yeah. And then what was your first big hit?
Be My Baby.
Yeah. And you were also a huge hit in Great Britain, weren't you?
Yes.
Yeah. You went over there and toured?
Yes, and it was quite exciting because the Rolling Stones were our opening act.
Now, this is amazing.
You know what I mean?
The Rolling Stones.
Look at them and look at me now, huh?
Now, that must have been an unbelievable thrill for you guys, huh?
What, to go over? Well, Beatlemania had all of America going crazy,
mm-hmm.
and that's what wiped us out.
Now, what you mean, but that was at the end of the girl group
that
sound,
was
pretty
the
much?
End of the girl group era, the black group era, the doo-wop era, the best era.
And why do you think that happened? What was it? Was there one reason?
Well, primarily because the Beatles came over and they just wiped us all out. And after that, it was either, if it wasn't the Beatles, it was the Rolling Stones, Dave Clark Five,
yeah.
Herman Termes. I could go on forever with the British groups.
You got to be good friends with the Beatles?
Oh, very good.
Yeah, how did that happen? In London or over here?
Over in London, they gave us a party. This is just before the Beatles were Beatlemania.
Mm-hmm.
And they had a little hit called I Wanna Hold Your Hand in England. And they invited us, the Ronettes, to meet them, and they gave us a party, and that's how I met the Beatles.
Yeah. Now, when they came to this country, you entertained them some, didn't you?
A lot, no. I'm only kidding. No, but we did, and we were the only ones they really knew in America, group-wise, you know, performers and stuff, and so we sort of introduced them to a lot of people.
And you took them to a restaurant at one point?
We took them up to Harlem. Well, no, who would recognize them in Harlem, I mean? The Spanish guy on drugs, you know.
Where did you take them?
We took them to a place called Sherman's Barbecue. A really grease joint, you know.
Yeah, they
loved it.
They enjoyed it.
Yeah. We went there all the time.
Yeah. Now, you were...
there into my apartment between the two.
You were going to travel with them. The Ronettes were going to open for the Beatles then, right, on that tour?
Well, when they first... Their first United States tour, the Ronettes did tour with them, but I wasn't on the tour.
Now, how come you weren't on the tour?
Well, At that point, I was going with my ex-husband, Phil Spector, which produced and wrote and owned our record company.
Sure.
And he said, either you go on the tour with the Beatles, because I had dated Lennon a few times. Not dated, we went on dinner dates, Yoko dinner dates. And, you know, he was very, he
also,
was mad.
Phil was a little jealous, probably.
He said, either you go on the tour with the Beatles or you marry me.
Uh-huh. And you obviously...
And at the time, I was very much in love.
Uh-huh.
you know, I thought, oh, well, hey, he was my producer, my writer. I figured I'd get all the albums I wanted and stay at home and do the other thing, too.
Yeah. So you looked at it like you were set for life. We got to do a commercial here. Ronnie, and you're gonna sing another song for us?
I hope so. Do you want me to?
No, you're gonna sing another song. We'll be back with Ronnie Spector. Thank you, Paul. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here once again, singing, this time Walking in the Rain, Ronnie Spector. Ronnie Spector, folks. We'll be right back.
Mommy.
Thank you very much. You folks were terrific. I certainly appreciate it. What else? Anything else? Paul, you're here.
Yeah. I'm here. Steve Jordan is back from Paris.
Yeah, he was in Paris. What were you doing in Paris, Steve?
Recording with the two hippest acts in the world, Simon Le Bon, Nick Rhodes from Duran Duran. This is true, and the Stones, sitting in with the Rolling Stones over in Paris. So it's like he's not too hip for any. You know. Just the most happening acts, and you know, taking a little time out of his busy schedule to play with us here.
Nice to have you back.
Here
Thank you very much for being back. Paul, did you have a good weekend?
I had a nice weekend. I was swinging very hard, appearing with Ronnie Spector downtown in a nightclub and introducing her as Marie the K, and she brought me down the original Marie the K hat, his real hat, you know, the late, great Murray Kaufman, so I wore that. And how about you, David?
You know, when Eddie Money began work on this album right here entitled Can't Hold Back, there was only one person he wanted to sing with him on the cut, Take Me Home Tonight. That's right, it was me. No. It was the legendary Ronnie Spector. And here tonight, singing that song, it's a pleasure to welcome Eddie Money and Ronnie Spector. Is that your own or one of NBC's?
This is yours.
All right, then we'll turn that in at the end of the show.
Okay.
This is a great song. How did this happen? How did this come together?
Richie Zito, my producer, gave it to me and was taking me home tonight, and I thought it was kind of silly, kind of like Brian Hyland singing Itsy Bitsy Teeny Weeny Yellow Polka Dot Bikini. I feel a little funny. I'm married now. Take Me Home Tonight just wasn't working. As a matter of fact, my wife is singing the part on stage with me when we do it live. And I say after she does it, I go, you know, she keeps a beautiful house. You know,
Ronnie does a better job. That's very nice of you.
But we did
so,
it.
She has your complete support in the career.
Yes,
then.
She does.
But the song originally wasn't designed for Ronnie to be singing.
The song probably was written in L.A. by some guy with shades on ordering cocktails. We don't know really where it came from, but it turned out pretty good. And we had Martha Davis from Martha and Motels, who was also produced by Richie Zito, doing it.
Richie Zito is terrific, isn't he?
Yeah, he's
doing
sweetheart.
My album now.
It's fantastic.
And a couple of
how did you get around to including Ronnie in it?
Well, it said just like Ronnie sang in the demo, and I said, well, why don't we get Ronnie Spector? And he said, well, she's probably unavailable and stuff like that. So I called her. They said she's probably really busy, you know. So I called. I said, Ronnie, what are you doing? She says, the dishes. I said, you want to come out and sing on it? And since then, we've hosted MTV together, and we've had a lot of fun.
So are you going to travel together? Is that a possibility?
I'm trying to get it. Well, I tried to get her to come to Bakersfield, but no, she wouldn't. She's going to come to LA with us and hopefully do Northern California, and here we are in New York together.
Yeah, that'd be a lot of fun, I would think. How old were you when you first sang the song, when it was first recorded?
Oh, originally? Yeah. 16.
Oh, 16.
16 candles.
Yes,
how did you find the song in those days?
Oh, in those days.
Where did it come
Jeff
from?
Jeff Barry, Carol King. It was just a bunch of great writers in those days.
Yeah.
And it fit my voice.
Nice to see you again. And you've had your family has increased since we last saw
you. Yeah, a 2-year-old and a 3-year-old. Last time I was on your show, I was pregnant. I said, I didn't even notice.
Nobody noticed it, no.
It was 7 months. Boy, Dave must be blind or what?
Well, I have a lot of personal problems. We'll be right back. Okay, Eddie Money, Can't Hold Back. Richie Zito, by the way, produced this one. My thanks to everybody who was here tonight, Ronnie Spector, Eddie Money, and Martin Mull.
Tomorrow night, Linda Ellaby and Kid Inventors.
Good night, everybody. Always quite happy when our next guest comes back to visit us here on the program. This year, she was elected to the New York Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, and this is currently her most recent album entitled Unfinished Business. Folks, please welcome an American classic, Ronnie Spector. So that was your Christmas medley.
That album actually has been out for around 20 years.
Very nice. Nice to see it.
It wasn't a hit when it first came out.
And, of course, David Sanborn playing Jingle Bells.
Oh,
nice job,
David. David, I love him.
We'll see you next weekend or next Monday. Ladies and gentlemen, Paul Schaefer, everybody.
Thank you very much. Listen to this.
Yeah, all right. Ladies and gentlemen, on the program tonight, oh, here we go. The lovely Rachel Ray. We'll be right back to tonight's Top Ten.
Coming up, Top Ten Science, you're dealing with a Ben Bernanke imposter. And Rachel Ray. The Late Show is for amusement purposes only and is not intended as a flotation device. Stay tuned.
Gentlemen, the great Ronnie Spector, Paul Schaefer, and the band.
Thanks.
Thank you very much for being here tonight, Ronnie. Paul explained to us why Ronnie was nice enough to come in and be on the show tonight.
I gave Ronnie a call last night, middle of the night, and the reason is this, that we lost a couple of days ago one of the great writers of the rock and roll, of the rock and roll era. Her name was Ellie Greenwich. And with Jeff Barry and with Phil Spector, she wrote so many of the great songs that will live forever in infamy. I'm talking about Be My Baby. I'm talking about Baby, I Love You. I'm talking about Doo Wah Diddy. I'm talking about Doo Ron Ron. I'm talking about Hanky Panky. I'm talking about Chapel of Love. And it goes on and on and on and on. River Deep Mountain High, Ellie Greenwich, a great friend of ours, a great friend of mine, and I wanted to pay tribute to her tonight, and so I called up the great Ronnie Spector, and I said, come on down, we'll sing all of Ellie's songs.
Thank you very much.
So Ronnie is with us tonight.
Welcome all. Sorry.
Ronnie Spector.
I'm not singing them. David Letterman.
Thank you, Ronnie. We're going to pay tribute to Ellie Greenwich tonight.
Ellie Greenwich passed away a couple of days ago, 68 years old.
Yeah, not all of
that. Sad, very, very sad.
Too young.
Anyway, nice job, Paul, and nice job. Thank you very much,
Thank
Ronnie,
you,
for
David.
Being here. Yes, good to have you here. So all night long, we get to hear this.
You sure do.
Nice going.
Thank you.
Great.
Thank you, David.
Thank you, by gosh. Randy Roddick, everybody. Lovely, lovely, and thank you, and hello again. We'll be right back with Andy Roddick. Everybody. Nice job. So thanks for watching. Good night, everybody. Guest is a legendary singer and member of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, and her brand new collection of holiday music is entitled Ronnie Spector's Best Christmas Ever. Please welcome back to the program, Ronnie Spector.
Great job. Nice to have you with us. Thank you so very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Don't leave your wallet in the dressing room. Thank you. Nice to see you. Ronnie Spector, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh,
beautiful
Dave.
Job. Good
I
to
love
have
this
you here.
Guy.
I love you as well. It's Ronnie Spector's best Christmas ever.
Ever.
Thanks for watching. Good night, everybody.
Good night.
Now, stay tuned for Craig Ferguson. This is Alan Coulter speaking. Good night, everybody.